pent-up demand is boosting auto sales in the Philippines. Data from Compi and TMA show vehicle sales grew 16.7% in the first half of the year to 154,874 units. Can these gains be sustained amid high fuel prices and the rising cost of borrowing? Can we count on auto sales to help drive economic recovery? Well, we'll ask our next guest. Joining us this morning is Ford Philippines Managing Director Mike Breen. Mike, welcome to Market Edge. Hi.
Great. Thank you so much. I appreciate the opportunity to be with you.
All right. So far, so good. The auto industry seems like it's stepping on the gas, but can you sustain the momentum, though? I mean, have expensive gas prices affected your sales? And what about higher interest rates, which essentially makes auto loans all the more expensive?
Well, it's certainly the goal to continue the growth and the progress already made in the first half of the year, as you indicated. For us at Ford, we certainly continue to deliver strong sales, especially in the month of June, where we grew about 24%. To your point about the economy, interest rates, and challenges, really customers are interested in being in the market. You know, there are so many activities taking place right now. Customers coming out of COVID are really looking for opportunities to manage their own transportation requirements. And we find that that's certainly driving a lot of our activity and interest as we continue moving forward. Additionally, new products will certainly continue to drive that. And we've got a couple just on the verge of launching.
Mm-hmm. Looking forward to that. But so you're not seeing, you know, expensive fuel discouraging people from getting their own cars?
Well, it's certainly a consideration for Filipinos, but again, transportation is essential, and safe transportation actually adds to those requirements. So customers are just being very careful and understand, yes, there are implications associated with fuel prices. At the same time, people need to be able to get where they need to go. And certainly vehicles are the way to do that.
What about expensive, the rising interest rates that we have that's going to make auto loans expensive? In the previous cycles, financial crisis or not, what did you observe? Do expensive interest rates usually hurt auto sales or not so much?
Well, so interest always is a factor for customers, but in working with bank partners, whether it's Ford Motor Company or any other company, we certainly look at what the impact or the implications of that are on customers and work on identifying programs and initiatives that can support and assist customers first, certainly securing the vehicles, but then also having a sustainable finance solution that will drive success and be able to actually get in their vehicles, afford their vehicles, and enjoy their vehicles.
Mike, as the world reopens further, more people are back on the road. Are transaction prices generally up as well? What about incentives?
So really, there's a combination. As you're aware, the global semiconductor has created all kinds of supply and demand challenges. So in that universe, there are certainly things that are factoring into cost of ownership. But in general, as it relates to vehicles, the ideal or the most important thing to remember is that auto manufacturers have offerings across the board so that customers can identify the right vehicle and get into an affordable vehicle that really suits their needs and requirements.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's talk about Ford here in the Philippines. You're at number three for 2021, last year, number three, but quite distant from number one, which is a Japanese brand. You guys at number three sold around 20,000, over 20,000 units last year. Far from number one, the Japanese brand, which sold 130,000 units, and number two, also Japanese brand, which sold 30,000. Are you happy with your market share currently at number three, and what are the plans to grow this?
Well, thank you for the question. I appreciate it, certainly. And, you know, as anyone would acknowledge, there's a lot of competition in the automotive industry. And really, our opportunity is really identifying the right vehicles, bringing those vehicles into the market at very competitive pricing. And that's actually where, as I mentioned earlier, we've got two great new next generation Ford products in the next generation Ford Ranger and Everest that really appeal to and are really designed specifically for customer wants and needs here in the Philippines. So our focus is always to grow market share and increase market share, and we'll certainly plan to do that with the introduction of the next generation Ranger and Everest. And we've got so much to look forward to in partnership, certainly with our dealerships, And I think customers will find at launch, which we're actually conducting our launch on Thursday, I think customers will find that these products will certainly drive increased share and demand here in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned competitive pricing. How big have the price adjustments been on your sticker prices for cars sold here in the Philippines?
Yeah, so actually they range. It depends on what the vehicle is and what the series is. Our focus is to find a balance in those competitive segments. So when we introduce a new vehicle, we bring vehicles in that kind of carry a similar price point with nominal price increases. And then, you know, depending on the equipment and what a vehicle is equipped with and how customers are going to use it, the price certainly increases based on really content and what the requirements are for that customer. So it's really a focus on satisfying what the customer wants and then pricing accordingly so that they can afford it, with certainly bank partnerships that allow us to satisfy the requirements as you related to the interest rates.
Mike, could you give us a sense? I mean, right now, what kind and how big are your operations out of Manila? Do you have assembly plants here?
So we do not have any assembly plants, but the Philippines, the Ford Group Philippines is a national sales distribution subsidiary and certainly a Ford Motor Company based in the United States. We employ 55 employees here handling sales, marketing, and service, and certainly are always focused on improving the customer and ownership experience. At the same time, we have our Ford dealership network is present in 49 locations nationwide. And really, they're the strength of Ford Motor Company in the Philippines. And the customers, that's who customers interact directly with. And we depend fully on our dealer partners to make a difference and take care of those customers and ensure that they have a positive experience.
You mentioned your dealers. I'm very curious, you know, as we accelerate digitalization, are Filipino buyers starting to ditch traditional dealerships and move online? I know we know that car shoppers usually do at least a little bit of research about their cars they're planning to buy online, and then they buy it in store. Is this starting to change? And is this a direction that you're preparing for? More sales done online?
Yeah, so absolutely. There's an opportunity. I think the idea is kind of finding the perfect balance between our dealer partners and customer demands in e-commerce. And we certainly recognize that customers are certainly more digital savvy over the past years. And actually, we've just recently launched an online reservation portal. And that takes car buying experience to a whole next level, allowing customers to actually configure their vehicle, and then they can actually make a deposit online as well. And then that they can track their orders online. So it really does automate that process and improves the digital experience. At the same time, I think the important thing is it's a vehicle. Filipino customers especially love their vehicles. And so a piece of the equation will always be an experience in the dealership where they'll take delivery of the vehicle. They'll also certainly have the opportunity to test drive and experience the vehicle and ensure that the vehicle that they're choosing will actually fit their needs. So I would say it's finding the right balance that gives customers the digital experience that they want, in addition to the experiential component of when you buy a vehicle, you want to make sure you have the opportunity to drive.
So you're thinking this is going to be a hybrid setup, because in the U.S. I know that some platforms are already doing everything online, from reservation, payment, even delivery, up to possibly returning the vehicle for any trouble. All of that is done online. For Ford Philippines, you think it's going to be hybrid, that a piece of the experience will always be with the dealerships.
I certainly see our dealers as integral pieces. And even if it's not the customer going to the dealership, part of it may be part of our overall consumer experience activities, where customers can coordinate online with the dealership, whether it's to have their vehicle serviced at home, or if it's to pick their vehicle up and bring it into the dealership. So certainly the dealerships here in the Philippines will be at its core the foundation of the support for customers here in the Philippines. And to your point, yes, there will be certainly a hybrid version that enables customers to do what they want to do.
All right. Speaking of digitalization, let's talk about the future. How is your electric vehicles push? I know that overall, global Ford, you're looking at 2 million EVs by 2026. And the goal is for your electric vehicle sales to make up at least 50% of global sales by the year 2030. Are you on track? And do you expect, you know, the Philippines to be a big market for EVs, considering we don't have the infrastructure yet?
Right. I think it's a great question, and it's actually one that we get asked often. And we're always looking for opportunities to bring the right vehicles into the market at the right time, including EVs, certainly. Now, as you indicated, there's so many factors at play that we have to consider as we look at bringing EVs into the market. And certainly infrastructure, as you referenced, adequate charging stations, government policy. The key really for us is to integrate, coordinate, and align to the government and discuss what government policies can support bringing EVs into the market. So, you know, as always, we're looking for opportunities to bring the right vehicles into the market. But again, we have to ensure that, you know, there are sustainable long-term consumer demand, and we'll certainly continue to monitor and engage to determine what the right timing is for the Philippines as far as the future of EVs for Ford.
All about timing, but when you look at Asia, for example, which market is leading the EV race? Which market do you think is ripe for the picking?
Well, I would, in looking overall, I would say Singapore may potentially be, but I focus here in the Philippines, and so I don't have good line of sight into who has the best infrastructure to be able to support that. Overall, what we focus on is what can we do here? What's the customer demand here? And how do we set ourselves up for the long-term solution of bringing EVs into the Philippines?
Mike, just a little bit of context here. Help us understand. I know that a few months ago, it was reported that Ford was splitting the business into two. One would be the Ford Model E to focus on EVs. And then you've got the Ford Blue, which will, you know, keep to the traditional business, the internal combustion vehicles or ICE, which is still the bulk of the business right now, but is very critical because that's where you raise the money to fund the EV push. Would that be an accurate picture of how Ford operates today?
Yes, it's actually very accurate. And to your point, the idea is to leverage the foundation of all of the strengths of the Ford internal combustion engine lineup, because at its core, that's where the business is currently. And again, to your point, that's where the funding comes from that supports EV development. And it sets us up very effectively to ensure that we put the appropriate attention on Ford Blue, the foundational business currently, with the vision for how does that support in, you know, the benefits of the research, the development, the growth associated with Model E. So really, while you could view them as separate and distinct, they're actually very interconnected because you have to have the success of one in order to continue to move things forward in Model E.
All right, Mike, final question. It's the most basic one of all, but most important for our viewers. They want to buy a car. No shortage happening for your brand?
So with the launch of the next gen Ranger, next gen Everest,
no shortage.
We feel good. There are certainly a few challenges on the semiconductor chips, but we've been able to overcome those at launch. We'd love to be able to have free demand of everything that we're offering, but you know, we continue to work through that and we are making great progress. So we feel very good about availability, and the bottom line recommendation is you can go to our online portal at Ford.com, or you can make a reservation and then visit your Ford dealership for availability.
All right. So still some challenges for the auto industry, but improving at least. Thank you very much for joining us this morning, Mike. Always a pleasure speaking with you.
Great. Thank you very much. Have a great day.